Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Head Crack After Hours. It's a dude who people love and hate just as equally because he's that damn good. Ladies and gentlemen, you may have seen him on Power, but you also need to get to know him for his music. One time for the one, the only, Ro Timmy.
My brother, what's good, baby?
Yo, great to see you, bro.
As well, yo, as well.
As the tides ride high.
Yes.
Like, you got this new joint out right now called Love Rhythm.
Yes, sir.
That's doing some crazy numbers. I'm hearing something like 2 million streams in the first 2 days.
Yeah, something crazy, bro. It's a blessing, man, because when you get a record that connects with people and it's like the right time and everything is just working together, it's the best feeling in the world because so much hard work goes into it that people just don't see. So when it's received this way, the fact that Love Rhythm is in Spain and Portugal and Australia, you know, it's a beautiful feeling.
Yo, and the dope thing, you know something is on fire when you like just do a casual search and you see people, they already have like dance routines.
Yes.
They're like mad. Like pages,
pages, yeah.
So did you come up with the actual like dance, or these people just ran with it?
They ran. There's no dance to it. It's Love Rhythm is your own rhythm, you know, and that's the cool thing about it. So there's no actual dance to it. It's just people just wanted to be a part of it, man. So what I started doing was I started putting on my IG story like just different things around the world that people vibing to it. And so when people realize, oh, now he's actually posting us doing this.
Yeah.
They started, it became a roller coaster. So for the last 2 weeks, I've been doing it all day, every day.
Yo, and the crazy thing is, like, some people will sit in a room full of a bunch of marketing people, try to figure out, like, we need a gimmick. We need something to sell this. But, like, you did the no-look pass and it's joint in the basket.
Yeah, you know, sometimes, man, like, again, good music will just speak for itself, man. It's just a matter of people being aware of it. And once they're aware of it, it's our job to make you aware of it. But then once you hear it, you already know where it's going to go.
So this is an appetizer, I'd imagine, a larger body of work that's coming soon.
Because
you've been treating us like fish, dropping little part, you know, morsels in the fish tank, you know, to get them to come to the top, man. But where that whole album at, bro?
The whole project coming May 24th, man. I'm excited about it. It's called Walk With Me. Okay. And basically, it's basically saying, forget everything that I've done and anything else. Now, let me walk you through my journey as a musician. And let me take you and show you that I belong here. And Love Rhythm is the first one, but the whole project is filled with that, man. We took our time to make a project that had influences of Akon and Craig David with my style.
Okay.
And it's a whole fly gumbo of that. And if you love Love Rhythm, then you're going to definitely love Walk With Me.
Word. Now, you know, people, we as a people sometimes can be mad one-dimensional.
Yeah.
We see you do one thing, and we have a hard time processing that you could do something else.
Yeah.
You do such a great job in front of that camera, man,
Power. Thank you, bro.
I imagine you have to, like, work almost a little bit harder, where some people would think that would be an easy alley-oop.
Right.
But you are such an unlikable guy on the show that, like, you know, and here you come with this, you know, with this love vibe and a whole different energy.
Yeah.
Have you found yourself having to fight your way to, like, you know, get people to take you serious?
Nah, not at all, because again, like, the music speaks for itself. So if you just know me from Power, of course it's all you're gonna think I'm doing. But if I put you on a record like a Love Rhythm or a Want More or whatever it is, it's undeniable music, you know? So, like, it just helps to say, okay, damn, he's actually really talented. And that's the thing. I want people to just understand that I'm a creative, man. I've been singing since I was 5. I've been doing this way before acting. I started acting 6 years ago, you know? And that was because I booked my first audition and got thrown into the acting world. I was just trying to get money to do a commercial, but I ended up auditioning for this TV show called Boss. And the first audition, I booked it, so now I'm this actor now.
Wow.
That's what I got thrown into it, basically. It was God's timing, but it wasn't a plan to do this. I was just off tour when I with WizKid and them in 2011 when I had just did the situation with the acting. So it was never a plan, but God is good. So now Power, you know, came from that as well.
Yo, it's crazy. I feel like some people in life got what I like to call the Walgreens door treatment.
Okay.
You know, you just walk up to the door, Walgreens just opens for you.
Yeah.
You don't even really gotta put forth the effort.
Yeah, Because,
because that joint, you say Billions, right?
A boss.
Boss. Yeah. That was with Kelsey Grammer.
Kelsey Grammer. Yeah.
You know, it didn't really go, like, super long series-wise, but people love that show.
People loved
and
it,
ended just in time for you to get
into
on
Power,
which is, like, it's ingrained in urban culture for the rest of our lives now.
Yeah, you know, and to be a part of something so epic, man, and so iconic is a blessing. And I wouldn't be able to musically be where I'm at if it wasn't for Power 2 to open up some of the doors that it's opening. So what it did was a stepping stone for me. And now it's allowing me to say, okay, y'all like this, but this is really what all I do, you know? And so that's the blessing of it all. So I want to get involved in a lot of things. I'm executive producing now. I got a movie coming out called Singleholics that, you know, I step behind the camera and see the executive producing side of things so I can have that mailbox money. You know what I mean? But that's the whole thing, man, even getting into real estate. So it's about a lot of different things that I really want to do, but I'm grateful for Power, for
sure.
Got
you. Now, you know, keeping it on the movie and film set real quick. The last season of Power was just epic. Like, every time, it seems like Dre is done. You figure it out. Like, you know, you a bad... Like, I don't want to see nothing bad happen to you on the show. Because I know you off the show. So it's like, man, but like, Dre be so foul with it, but he be pulling it off. Like, you look so finished when they ran up on the crib when you was in there with Shorty. But like, somehow, some way, Dre always figures it out.
He's a cat, man. He got nine lives, man. And again... You know, with that in real life, man, it's a testament to how much the writers, like, respect my craft. You know what I mean? Because it's one of those characters where you want him to die, but you don't really want him to die because it's so entertaining.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? So, like, the fact that they trust me so much to be able to do what I do and to make it to a season six in anything, you know, is a blessing. So this season, man, like, I pushed myself so hard because... The vulnerability in Dre this year is crazy. Like, you get to meet him as a man, as a human being now, not just a monster. You get to see what he has to deal with, even with his daughter. You know what I mean? So everything is coming together, and, you know, it's a beautiful, beautiful season, bro. And for me, too, personally, working on this season was hard because I was filming, I was working on my album the same time. So I'll be on set from 11 a.m. to 9 p.m., go to the studio, 10 p.m. to about 7 a.m., sleep in the studio, record, and I did that for about a month and a half, 2 months, man.
Back at it.
And that's how you just got
to
do it.
Yo, work ethic is crazy, and it's also a testament to your acting ability because the hardest thing to pull off is a likable bad guy. You know what I'm saying? Like, most people, they come through, you the bad guy, and it is what it is. There's no depth to it, but... We see behind, like, you know, all the layers of the character. Be like, all right, cool. What's his real motive to this? And then we feel, oh, we got a daughter. Oh, okay, cool, cool. Yo, we got to protect his family,
right?
We got to
protect his family, And it's cool because this season, it puts people to think, what would you do if you were in his situation? And it makes people reflect on that on themselves. Like, damn, I would do the same thing, as bad as it is. But you get to see that, and for reasons why, you know, you got to tune in.
The crazy thing about that show is, like, when you really look at it, like, everybody on that show is effed up. Like,
everybody. Yo, Ghost is the worst one.
Absolutely.
Yo, Ghost has caught the most bodies. He's cheating on his wife. He neglects his children. Like, I was like, Jesus. And it's like, well, stay away from my baby daddy, Ghost. I'm like, this guy is the worst, yo.
They always go aim the gun at the guy smiling. It's him. He's the guy. You know?
Right.
So, I know recently, Oprah Winfrey, she did an interview. Man, she was talking about, like, you know, she don't want to act no more because it no longer feeds her soul.
Right.
What feeds Rotimi's soul?
Honestly, man, music, bro. And I'm not saying that to be cliche, but, like, I'm the happiest when I'm in the studio. I'm the happiest when I'm on stage. I'm the happiest when I'm playing my song for someone just to see, like, because it's an expression of me. It's a piece of me. I think being on Power, though, is the closest thing to being as fulfilling as an artist because you're still affecting people in a very, very deep way, too.
Yeah.
But music all around, man. Like, you could listen to your favorite song 5,000 times and you can only probably watch your favorite movie 5, 6. It's a different connection with people. So I love the music, man. I love the music.
Yo, and great songs that really pull people out of dark moments.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's
like
sometimes, like, you could be in a low place, but that right song will put you right back where you need to do.
Yeah.
And, like, love.
Yes, love.
It's such a commonality
amongst
things that people, you know, find joy in and make happy. So how can you hate a love rhythm?
How can you hate a song called
Happy by Pharrell? Like, make you feel better.
Exactly, bro. And I see on my page in the Instagram and, like, the DMs and stuff, it'll be like, man, like, I'm 40 years old with 4 kids and it's so stressful, but when I listen to your song, it puts me in such a happy place. So, like, I'm not sad anymore. And the fact that you can spread love through music like that, man, like, I'm so happy about that. Like, even the videos I'm getting of these people just smiling and happy, like, babies are dancing to this song, bro. And, like, it's a beautiful thing, brother.
You know, it's the polar opposite of some records that are out there. Like, you know, like, there's clubs I go to and I host, and, like, a certain song will come on and people literally, like, raise their hands in the air and start punching their fist in their hands. And it's like, no. Like, let's not fuck each other up. Let's not do that.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
So, Yo, what up, y'all? It's the Weekend Crackdown in the studio. We got Ro Timmy. That's his brand new record, yeah. Love Rhythm.
Uh-huh.
If you listen close enough, you can hear people finish getting pregnant. You've done it, bro.
Hey.
You've done it.
Thank you, man.
You've
thank
increased you. The population.
Yes, thank you. Thank
as opposed
you.
To raise the murder rate.
Hey, that's what I'm here for.
You out here doing God's work. You don't even know it,
you
bro.
You see what I'm saying? Thank y'all, man. Thank y'all. It's a blessing, bro. Like, this record feels so good, and I'm so excited because I'm finally at a place, man, where I know the type of artist I am, and I know the man I am now, and so everything is clicking at the right time, and it's just I'm trying to be the new Harry Belafonte, bro.
Dope.
You get what I'm saying? I see this record being my banana, you know, banana song, like the Deo record. So I really believe in it.
So I need everybody out there right now to pull out their phones,
yes.
Set an appointment in their Google Calendar or whatever calendar they're using on their phones.
Yeah.
May 24th is the day.
May 24th.
The album is dropping. Yes. The album is called.
The album is called Walk With Me. May 24th, Love Rhythm is out right now. Get it anywhere, everywhere. You'll enjoy.
Yo, walk with Ro Timmy.
Hey.
And how long will we have to walk until the next season of Power kicks off?
You're going to have to walk a little longer. It's probably the end of summer.
God, dog, we walk into August? Is that what we're doing right now?
Sometime, I don't know, brother. You know, somewhere around there.
Are you still filming right now?
Yeah, we're still filming, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
So I'd imagine because how big this show is,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
because, you know, there's like sometimes a slow rollout. Like, we over here in the States, then the UK get it.
Yeah.
Then they start overdubbing you in foreign languages.
Yeah.
What's the craziest language you saw yourself speaking on TV?
I think it was German.
Word.
Because none of the words were matching any of the things I was saying.
So the context was all
bad? It was just like, I would stop talking and it would still keep going. That it was just weird. But again, it's a testament to how big this show is, man.
Yeah, they put a lot more letters in their words over there.
Yeah. It was kind of cool. It was cool, but it was just like, it was weird. It was a little weird, but it was dope.
Gotcha. Now, you can be as savage as you want to be with this answer.
Yeah.
I would imagine, uh-huh. Right? Because the type of music you make it, the type of impact that the show has.
Yeah.
There are some blue checks sliding into the DMs,
1,000%,
right?
1,000%,
yeah. Trying to holler, right?
Oh, 1,000%.
Anybody we would know?
You know, if they got a blue check, I think you probably know, you know? But, yeah, it's
you
one of those.
You can buy a blue check.
Yeah, and you could.
There's some flat tummy T-models with a blue check.
I'll say this. I got a lot of dudes' dream girls in the DM.
Wow.
Yeah, and it's a blessing.
That's what's up.
Yeah, it's
well,
cool.
Yo, you keep serving the community. And by that, I mean, keep collecting those blue checks. These people are like Pokemon cards. You got to catch them all. Because you never know what next year is going to look like, man. So if people ain't following you, where can they go?
You can follow me at Rotimi Music, R-O-T-I-M-I Music on Instagram. Listen, if you're doing a Love Rhythm Challenge, put your best dance video, you singing the record. I post everybody's up, man. So definitely put, you know, check it out. And then Rotimi on Twitter. Love Rhythm is out now everywhere. Please go get it. I know y'all going to love it.
There it is, man. We can't crack down. That's the man right there. Head crack out the albums. Rotimi.
Yeah.
That record, we'll see you soon.
Uh-huh. Go. Let's get it.